Being an international student, I like to start my day with a video chat with my mom in Egypt. Here's usually what happens during the call. Hey, Hossam, I'm waving at you right now. No, mom, I don't see you. And then suddenly the call is dropped. What a frustrating event. Let's now together try to understand why this problem is happening for us and also know solutions for this problem. In World War II, to ship the milk with the available transportation, people first milked the cow, dehydrated that milk by removing as much water as possible, and then at the other end, they rehydrated that milk in order to reconstruct it in the best possible quality. Videos are also following a very similar concept. Instead of the cow, we have the camera capturing the sequence of frames, or the so-called video. Instead of the dehydration, we have the encoding. And instead of the rehydration, we have the decoding that displays the video in our devices. My thesis objective is to dehydrate the video as much as possible while maintaining its high quality. Now, take a good look at those two frames coming from the same video. As you see, those two frames look very similar. Our task now is to encode those two frames. To do so, first, we send frame one nearly as is to the other end. Second, we send the residuals, which is the amount of change between frame one and frame two, to the other end. Adding those residuals to frame one reconstructs frame two at the other end. Currently, there are two strategies for generating those residuals. One, the black picture on top, the aggressive way. It removes the majority of the content details of the residuals. It's good for the size, but will produce poor quality, and you do not want that. Two, the non-aggressive way. It preserves as much content details as possible from the residuals. That one will produce high quality, but it will have a huge video size that will go over the channel's cap, leading to a code drop, and you do not want that either. What you really want, and I achieved in my solution, is a balanced trade-off between strategy one and two, or the video quality and the size. The way we do that is described in the bottom left. It's by learning information from the past frame, such as the content similarity and how the frames were dehydrated, in order to adjust the quality of the present frames. Our method performs significantly better than other methods in the literature, and we still strive for more. Now, let's step back from this for a moment. Imagine a world where I can see my mom's wave every day. Even you, can attend events that you cannot attend for whatever reason. We aim at a world right at your fingertips. Thank you for listening.